This type of moss that we're working with does not have roots that collect water from the soil. So it gets all of its water from condensation or fog or raindrops. So it can grow on a very dry desert, and as long as it's got humid air around, it can get all of its moisture out of the air. The mystery was, how do these plants survive so well in the desert when it only rains once or twice a year? And the answer was that they can collect water throughout the year because they have structures that allow them to collect from moist air or from fog. Our Chinese collaborators noticed that these little leaves have a hair on them, and if they clipped off the hair, then the moss didn't grow as well as moss that has hair on it. We noticed that these hairs had little tiny nano-sized grooves that run down the length of the hair. These grooves are hundreds of nanometers. That's like about 1/100th of the size of a human hair. We used some BYU equipment to put a little hair inside of an electron microscope, and so we can change the temperature and the pressure in this chamber, and lo and behold, water formed in those little grooves. They collect all this water and make it into a big droplet, and then that droplet zips away down towards the leaf. These are the folded up dried leaves, and you can see that these hairs are starting to move a little bit in the breeze. And now I see a water droplet there, one there, one there. These zip so fast that sometimes we can't see them disappear. All of the leaves are starting to unfold as the water is zipping down to the leaves. The forces that propel this droplet toward the leaf structure are so strong that the droplet can flow upward against gravity or horizontal. A rain droplet impacting on this moss doesn't splash all over the place. The rain droplet hits, and all of these hairs absorb that impact and collect all of the water. I think the most fascinating thing is to watch those water droplets form and zip, form and zip. And that's amazing that a plant can do that kind of collection. It just has the right structure. These plants have been doing this for millions of years, and they have developed a very efficient system. So I think we can learn from that, and we can learn about how to collect water in a desert.